Baroda is a small town compared to Bombay. I've been working in Baroda since last 28 years. I think temples, mosques, churches are very much part of our living. They form essential part of my painting. These gods and goddesses are almost next door neighbors or someone who stays upstairs. Naturalistic painting has not interested me. My interest is mostly in the narrative painting. The time sequence in painting interests me. In 1970-71, I started doing paintings based on professions. I used the colors that were used by middle class people, particularly shocking pink, green and blue. I'm happy with these paintings, though I did not sell these paintings for a long time. I use the things around us. I use colors of posters, garish and vulgar. At present, I am interested in play of light in my painting, the way light falls on objects, the way things get illuminated. I have been collecting these oleographs since 1962. Right in the beginning, the things which I had collected are from the cinema posters, the gods and goddesses posters, and also very late miniatures. All these things had interested me. These things have been ignored because they are considered as things which are on periphery of art. The earlier work, like a tailor, watch repairer, is a satire on the existing work being done. Certain things which I thought I had no courage to say, I needed some courage to say. So I had used totally different way of approaching the problem. Slowly I could gather the courage and say these things. Things which interested me started coming. The problems of transvestite, problems of homosexuality, problems of so many things, which I was not able to depict on the canvas. Slowly, I could do it in the later work.
Although I do paint things about people who are on the street, I don't go down onto the street and sketch. What I like to do is observe as much as I can, or at least incorporate in my mental space much that I see around me, and I have been seeing around me for the 12 years that I have worked in this studio, and then come back to my studio and recall all that I have observed. And this is how I actually work. I mean, I like the stress of recall. I like the stress of, you know, the strain of recalling from memory, pulling it through various screens almost, and then bringing forth a figure. I had started working on the watercolors in 1983, and the idea started because I had to vacate my studio, which was under repair, and I had a very small space to work in at my home. And it was really starting in a very small way, in a very small format. So it was at this point that I started to do the watercolors. After having done a whole series, I showed them to a friend, Nilima Sheikh, and she introduced me to the works of an artist, a Turkish artist called Siyakalem, which she felt it was important for me to see at that point. And I think that was really something fantastic. Siyakalem is a series of pictures done by Turkish nomadic artists of the 15th century, wandering in the deserts and recording the nomadic lives of the tribes of that area. And with the poverty of means, it's simply washes of sepia and bunsiana and Persian blue. Even little flecks of gold at times, I guess when they had little money, they could just afford to put a little bit of gold in. With just this, they were able to record the most marvelous things, you know, dervishes and fakirs. And I think that was for me a revelation. Series about conversations with artists of the past who have played a vital role in my art perceptions. The works entitled Rethinking Raja Ravi Varma and Marsha and the Vermeer Women are from this series. The picture entitled Of Monsters and Angels, a fable, is about reinventing figures from the miniature painting traditions and placing them in post-colonial times, signified by the appearance of the Occidental angel. Another set of pictures manifests the city, my city, Bombay, the areas and locales that I encounter every day. Beneath the mundane skin lies an alternate world which reveals itself only when it's not being looked at. That is, when it is absorbed in itself and does not rise to meet your gaze. I'm curious about the possibility of painting states of one's mind. I do not wish to be mystical at all. By states of mind, I'm referring to emotions that grip one in ordinary context of one's life, like oppression, anxiety, self-absorption, anger. When I paint this figure, I put in the posture all at once with a loaded brush, like a mark. And that mark has in it the germ of the stoop, the gesture, the facial expression, all of it incorporated in that very instant. I do pictures of the human face out of a passionate obsession. These are faces of people I have been meeting for many years. I walk down my street where my studio is situated in Lohar Chal. It is the Pathiwala waiting in the rain.